Right, guys, I'm coming at you today with some general maintenance on my 88 GMC K1500 single cab short bed. I've had this truck for about 15 years, and the voltage has always been pretty low when it's running and charging. This is a pretty new alternator. Put this in, I think, last year, and then this is a new-ish battery. But when it's running, it only charges about 12.5 volts, and I'll show you why. This truck has a Holley Sniper in it, and this is the voltage reading that's coming straight off the battery. As you can see, it's about 13 volts, and then over here the stock volt gauge is reading pretty low, maybe 13 volts or so. But by the time you turn anything on, this truck has dual electric fans and air conditioning, and by the time all that stuff's running, it'll drop down to just above 12 volts. Guys, so I'm gonna get up my multimeter here and set it to DC voltage. Then we're gonna come up here and put one lead on the charge post on the back of the alternator. We're gonna put the other lead on the positive battery cable. So this is gonna show us the voltage drop that we have going between the alternator and the battery. Alright, so as you guys can see by those readings, we have some high resistance in our wiring, which is causing us some voltage drop, about 1 volt between the alternator and the battery. Alright, so you guys have probably all heard of the Big Three upgrade, where you run supplementary battery cables from the alternator to the battery and then the ground. So that's basically what we're going to do today. These OBS Chevys are pretty notorious for electrical failures and just the electrical system in general. So what I did was I went and bought about 3 feet of this 2-gauge battery cable and some 3/8 lugs. So I just crimped these on here, did some heat shrink, and then this is just some nylon protective sheathing. So you guys have probably all seen these before. This one is called a Timco Industrial Battery Crimper. I got it off of Amazon. There's a lot of people that make these. So basically the way you run this thing is you put your terminal in there with the cable inside of it, put this kind of guillotine thing down on there, and then just hit the top with a hammer, and you get a nice, pretty decent crimp on there, just like this. I watched a few other videos online, and some people are getting really carried away with the double zero gauge thin strand welding wire and all that. But this is just a, I think it's a 90 or 105 amp stock alternator, and it's a pretty short run. Like I said, it's only 3 feet. So everything that I saw looked like this 2-gauge would be plenty. But let me know what you guys think. here's what we ended up with. This 2-gauge coming out of the battery there. And coming over here to the back of the alternator. All right, now we're gonna run all three voltage tests again. The post on the back of the alternator to the positive to measure the voltage drop, and then the post on the back to the negative, and then positive to negative on the battery and see what we got. Full disclaimer, guys, I had some of this 8-gauge left over from when I did my dual fan wiring installation, and I was trying to chase this problem down a few days ago. I figured I would just throw some of this in there, see if it would give me a little better voltage, and it did, but as you can see, it got a little toasty and started melting things. So I think the 2-gauge would be good, but probably unless you have a big stereo system or something, probably not quite necessary to go with the 0 or 00 that some people are going with. Alright guys, that's it for now. Let me know if you've had any other OBS Chevy wiring gremlins and what you did to fix them. Thanks.